Sanchi is a Buddhist complex famous for its great stupa on a hilltop at Sanchi town in Raisen district of the state of Madhya Pradesh, India. It is located about 23 kilometers from Raisen town, district headquarters, and 46 kilometers northeast of Bhopal, capital of Madhya Pradesh. The great stupa at Sanchi is one of the oldest stone structures in India and an important monument of Indian architecture. It was originally commissioned by the Mauryan Emperor Ashoka the Great in the 3rd century BC. Its nucleus was a simple hemispherical brick structure built over the relics of the Buddha. I'm entering into this most sacred and beautiful place. Sacred in the sense it is complete with purity and aesthetically pleasing with sanctity, and beautiful as it looks calm, as if Lord Buddha's presence is felt everywhere. It was a rainy day, so the entire area was wet. The reflection from the red sandstone path added beauty to the area. The southern gateway of Stupa 1. This gateway is one of the four richly carved gateways or tornas surrounding Stupa 1. It is the main one, as it was erected in front of the steps by which the terrace was ascended. The southern gateway was also the first to be erected, then followed in chronological order the northern, eastern, and the western, their succession in each case being demonstrated by the style of their carvings. It is probable, however, that not more than 3 or 4 decades intervened between the building of the southern and western buildings. A few of the surfaces of the southern gateway are undecorated or lost. Like the other gateways, the southern gateway is composed of 2 square pillars surrounded by capital, which in turn support a superstructure. Pillars of the southern gateway features lions in the manner of the pillars of Ashoka. They are the only pillar capitals of the Sanchi complex to do so. The railing created a path for devotees to walk around in the revered stupa. Forms of the world around us were made on the railings and gateways. Their representation helps us to appreciate all forms of life in their true perspective, to see them as reflections of the formless, eternal truth. Beyond the railings and gateways is the stupa to point out the truth towards which we must strive, leaving behind the attractions and attachment to the world. The 9-foot high Vediga and the Torana are made in imitation of the wooden architecture of that time. This is the earliest stupa railing to have survived. Unlike the imperial art of the Mauryan inscriptions, here show that the relief and figures were donated by the lay people, monks and nuns. Images of yakshas and yakshis come to us from times immemorial. These embodies the spirit of nature and serve to remind us of the divinity which underlines all that is around us. They represent the protection of nature and its great fertility, which ensures the continuance of life. On the left of the north gateway of the Vediga is made the Yaksha Kubera, who symbolizes abundance. On the same pillar is carved the Yakshi Chandra, where she is shown holding a branch of the Ashoka tree. Above her, the tree yearns for the touch of a beautiful woman to then burst into blossom. She entwines herself like a creeper around the trunk of the tree. The deity of prosperity and abundance, Lakshmi, is also made on the Vediga. This is the earliest image of the deity, who is later seen in the stupas of Sanchi and in other Buddhist art. Lakshmi is also a popular deity in other Indic traditions. The world of existence is seen as deeply connected. All that is around us is a path of the greater one. Therefore,
The artist saw no problem in joining different forms of plant, animal or human life in a fully harmonious depiction.
As the worshipper goes around the stupa, stories made on the railings remind him of the virtuous qualities of the Buddha. Jatakas or tales of the previous lives of the Buddha are used to exemplify the rules of conduct in every life. We are constantly aware the cosmopolitan world in India at that time, a pillar of the Vedika has a depiction of a Greek warrior. On another railing, we see a Nagaraja, a serpent king. He is in human form but has a certain school. Like Yakshas and Yakshinis, Naga deities serve to keep us conscious of the power, the protection and the fertility of nature. Serpents appear in Indic art from the Indus Valley times till today. Many of the roundels in the Vedika have lotus medallions. Human figures are also made within these. In Indic thought, the lotus is a symbol of purity and of rising above the mundane of transcendence. The Vedika reliefs depict many scenes from the life of the Buddha and from his previous lives. The Buddha is himself never depicted in this early Buddhist art. Instead, there are symbols which indicate his presence. One of the remarkable aspects of early Indian art is that the focus was not on individuals and there were no portraits even of kings. In fact, in the Chitra Sutra of the Vishnu Dharmotra, it is the eternal theme and not personalities which are the befitting subject of art. The focus in the art of the early stupas is on the ethical message. It is this ethical message which is contained in the Jataka stories made on the Vedika of the stupa. One of the marvelous aspects of the art of this period is that sublime character where even in humans is presented in the sculpted animals of the Jataka stories. This is a view of the world which makes no distinction between the life of man and that of the animals and even plants and trees. The city of Vidisha was on the trade route which connected the plains of the Ganga to the western coast. It was also a great marketplace at the center of the vast and fertile plains of central India. At Sanchi, on a low hill close to Vidisha, of the finest surviving early Buddhist stupas, halfway up the hill is a stupa which contains the remains of prominent Buddhist teachers of the Maurya period. The Vedika made around the stupa dates to around 100 BC. The Vedika has medallions and half medallions with relics corner pillars at the entrances is fully carved. The deity of prosperity and abundance, Lakshmi, is here being illustrated by elephants who pour water over her. The relics is shallow and the style is similar to that of Barhud. The greatest surviving Buddhist stupa of the BC period is on the top of the hill at Sanchi. It is likely that it would have enshrined the relics of the Buddha. The stupa was originally made in the 3rd century BC. There is an Ashokan pillar at the southern entrance of the stupa. In the middle of the 2nd century BC, the stupa was doubled in size and its other wooden railings were replaced with massive stone ones. By the end of the 1st century BC, the Satvahanas, kings of Deccan region, extended their rule to central India. They worship Brahminical deities. However, major stone renovations here during their time made the stupa one of the most significant of all Buddhist monuments. Four gloriously carved stone tornas 34 feet high were made. They were completed in the 1st century AD. The tradition of art established in the time of the Shunkas achieved greater sophistication in these magnificent tornas. 631 inscriptions on the tornas tell us that the carvings were the donations of the people of Vidisha. The art was created for gardeners, merchants, bankers, fishermen, housewives, nuns and monks. Almost half the donations were from women. The massive vedigas are plain and without carvings. The sculpted toranas have two upright pillars which support three horizontal bars or architraves. The west gateway has dwarfs who support the finely carved bars of the torana. The dwarf octagons are made with rolls of fat and vast bellies which bulge over their dhotis. They have individualized facial expressions. Ganas continue as a favorite theme of the Indian artist in the centuries to come. They deepen the sense of the reality presented in art, where the humorous and the sublime coexist, reminding us that everything has its place in existence. On the east torana is a beautifully carved yakshi who holds the branch of a mango tree above her. The notion of the creative vitality of nature, of its fruitfulness, is convincingly portrayed here. The relics on the toranas bring us the jatakas of Buddha's previous life as well as the events of the life of Gautama Buddha. The settings of the story, which re-reflects the lives of the towns and villages of the time when the art was created. The Sanchi relics are the most important visual record of the architecture and lifestyles of the period. The focus is still not on the personality of Gautama Buddha. Buddha's presence is represented by symbols. The wheel represents the first teaching of the Buddhist Dharma. The Bodhi tree represents enlightenment, while footprint and an umbrella or vacant space reclaim the presence of the enlightened one. Sanchi was a prosperous city until about 12th century. This place has been left abandoned and was overrun with vegetation when it was discovered in 1818 by British General Henry Tyler. Restoration work began in 1881 and was completed in 1919 under the supervision of Hubert Marshall, Director General of Indian Archaeological Survey. The great stupas and Sanchi's other Buddhist monuments were collectively designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1989.